Are you ready for some jaw-dropping, filament-popping action? Well, if I got a treat for you. In over 100 videos I've made on the sun, this has to be one of the coolest things I've ever seen. Boom! A circular coil filament liftoff. Which I would have to classify as a coronal mass ejection because the coronal just ejected a large mass. And not only does it look crazy on this camera, it looks crazy on stereo as well. On the core 2, it looks like the sun just shot out a bird ship. That is wild. Back over at the SDO. I'm not used to watching filaments tear off the north section. You know what I'm saying? Watch, check this out. Watch right there.
Yeah, we saw the one last time, remember? The vertical filament. Whoa.
Look, wow. Wow, look at how the perfect circle filament almost replaces itself instantly. Boom! Flies off the sun and then it fills right in to its filamenty levels. That's crazy. Share weird weather on the way. Weirder weather on the way.
Hello, world. Surprising but true. Every day on average, record snowfall, killer tornadoes, devastating floods. There's no doubt about it. The weather in the USA has been positively wild. But why?
Hit the button, baby. Stay cool. You're acting weird. This is a Thor News presentation.
Party game time.
Thor News presents. It's Sunday. And I'm looking at the sun action that is taking place since March started. We've had a steady stream of coronal mass ejections. Now I warn you, I've had a couple shots in NyQuil. Cause I got a cold. Cause it got cold. But the sun is hot. And that's what we're talking about. You got a circular CME on the 3rd. You got a blast on the 7th. You got a major vortexal spiral liftoff on the 8th. You get a double tinies on the 10th or 11th. And then a giant major liftoff on the 12th. That's pretty incredible. That looks like a lot of mass, matter, and semi-solid gaseous light. Yeah. Whoa. Due to the high solar activity, I expect Earth weather to get weird, stay weird, be weird, and just weird it up. So, watch those rain bands, the Sarah prayers. And head to higher ground when we need to. Everybody love Core 1. We get an amazingly smooth reptile tail CME. What I like about this camera, it makes the sun look like it dirty aquarium. Man, this Nyquil is messing me up. The sun being messed up and the Nyquil messing me up. Imagine this solar video is gonna be a collection of mess ups. Wow. One of the most well-defined coral mass ejections I've ever seen on the stereo head core one. And that's all I have to say about that. From this point, the sun looks like a bird or a phoenix with giant wings and a little tail. Looks like there's a spaceship in the middle. I sound funny. Observing on the Nyquil. And then you got the giant circular. That's wild. And the sun is the white circle in the center. You can see our permanent gravity waves in here. Well, and looks like you got tiny columns of gravitational waves going on in our dirty solar aquarium. You can see our permanent gravity waves in here. As the planets Earth and Jupiter ride on candlesticks, giant bridges of light extend out to nowhere. It's like the sun is shooting smoke rings around the planets. That's pretty neato. Hey, that smoke ring looked high and away. Or maybe it's shooting at some other planetoid we can't see. One within our own solar system, of course. Maybe a comet. Whoa. That was yesterday. Massive sea of meat. Now here we try to catch Sage's natural reaction.
Herbalocor 2. Whoa! Whoa, what was that? That was like some triangle geometric shape.
With about 52 coronal mass ejections in the 2 weeks of March, it's clear that solar activity is way low.
Super low. Like the lowest I've ever seen. Especially with that second occulting disc that just kind of pulses there. And I don't know, the cat hair of doom looks like it's moving. Whoa. Wow. It's just non-stop ejecting.
That's what she said.
Like, seriously, look, every day, it's just non-stop. Wow.
Watch this, the big finale.
Whoa. Dark matter flare.
Dark matter flare.
It pulses. Wow, do you see this? The orange? That looks like Ronald Dahl hair. Holy wow. Because it's not the same.
Say a giant heart. The sun was sending its heart to somebody.
I mean, it's just incredible to me the amount of mass, matter, particles, plasma that just keeps coming out the sun every day.
Every day.
Every day. Like, look, what is this? It's like a baby bird, you know, Trying to get the worm out. Here's his little body. Okay, and then they put like a second occulting disc. That's like occulting disc three.
Sun keeps contributing to the interstellar medium that we're going through.
Or maybe he's trying to clear a path, you know, through the interstellar medium.
Interstellar.
Sorry.
It's like a long duration flare with a lot of ejected mass.
It really seems like it's a non-stop, continuous. Wow, is that Jupiter? His candlesticks lighten up.
These are Jupiter moons. Three of them, they all happen to be in the candlestick. Interesting.
Well, because let's say that we're actually tilted. Because let's say we all have rings, right? And this is the ring system. So who's to say? Like they show us the pictures that it looks like that, and the moons go around. Well, just tilt it. Maybe it's coming at us top down, you know? So that would be his ring system. Those would be the planets.
Right. Moons of Jupiter.
The four Galilean moons of Jupiter.
The four Galilean moons. Did you know Galileo invented those moons?
Well, he discovered them, but you can't see them, you know, when Jupiter's close and it's a clear night. You can see them. No specs. I mean, the sun is the little white circle in the